Behind her eyes, the new Netflix show seems like your run-of-the-mill psychological thriller miniseries. Until it suddenly does not. Where many similar shows would be content to devote their entireties to dissecting the bivouac of childhood trauma, addiction struggles, and marital issues set up within this series' first few episodes, Behind Her Eyes decides instead to stray just a teensy bit from that well-worn path by throwing dashes of witchcraft, arson, and murder plus a healthy dose of supernatural body switching into the mix. But while all of that may be extremely difficult to believe, astral projection and lucid dreaming are actual phenomena. So what is lucid dreaming? The first step to being able to launch your soul onto the astral plane at will is mastering the practice of lucid dreaming. A long-standing concept that gained a much broader audience a decade ago thanks to Inception. Lucid dreaming allows a sleeping person not only to become conscious of the fact that they are in a dream but also often to take control of the dream and change its storyline as they see fit. It is a well-documented practice that has been around for centuries, confirmed through scientific study and used for the treatment of post-traumatic stress disorder and nervous system damage. So what is astral projection? There certainly have been documented cases of out-of-body experiences in which a near-death situation, neurological trauma, or hallucinatory drug can send a person into an involuntary dissociative state. It is hard to nail down what an out-of-body experience feels like exactly. According to accounts from people who have experienced them, they generally involve a feeling of floating outside your body, an altered perception of the world such as looking down from a height, the feeling that you have been looking down at yourself from above, or a sense that what's happening is very real. Some estimates suggest that at least 5% of people have experienced the sensation associated with an out-of-body experience, though some suggest this number is higher. The key difference between an out-of-body experience and astral projection is that an OBE is usually unplanned. But on the other hand, an astral projection usually involves an intentional effort to send your consciousness from your body. Astral projection is anything but new. It's been around since ancient times, strewn throughout various cultures and religions, but its most recent resurgence in the Western world occurred in the late 1800s. Lucid dreaming is actually fairly simple to attempt. There are a variety of methods, just a Google search away, but one of the most common revolves around building habits throughout your walking life that will carry over to your dreams to serve as a reality check. You might remember that the characters in Inception carry various totems around that act differently depending on whether you are in the real or dream world. While the characters in Behind Her Eyes rely on habits like pinching themselves, constantly telling themselves they are awake by checking clocks and counting fingers. Meanwhile, astral projection is not nearly as simple, nor are its methods as widespread. There will be people who will tell you that it is not even real. Fortunately for anyone looking to send their soul on a quick vacation, there are studies that show voluntary out-of-body experience a very much real thing. A study done in School of Psychology in University of Ottawa, Canada, showed a participant that reported being able at will to produce somatosensory sensations that are experienced as a body moving outside the boundaries of a physical body, all the while remaining aware of their unmoving physical body. The study also shows that the brain functional changes associated with the reported extracorporeal experience were different than those observed in motor imagery. Functional MRIs proved that activations were mainly left-sided and involved the left supplementary motor area and supramarginal and posterior superior temporal gyri. These are the parts of the brain that overlap with temporal parietal junction that has been associated with out-of-body experiences. The results suggest that the extracorporeal experiences reported here represents an unusual type of kinesthetic imagery. This was the first study with non-pathological participant who is able to elicit a self-initiated extracorporeal experience. The extracorporeal experience or the astral projection in the present study activated the left side of several areas associated with kinesthetic imagery and was associated with a strong deactivation of the visual cortex. This suggests that the experience was real and a novel one with a strong kinesthetic component. there were no brain abnormalities, thus providing a window into the brain during a non-pathological, self-elicited extracorporeal experience. It is in fact the first documented scientific proof of astral projection. Now, what is interesting is in the 1970s and 80s, the US Army attempted to find out by conducting research into psychic tests and phenomena including OBE and astral projection. Officers who worked as a part of Project Centerlane were hypnotized, then attempted to reach the astral plane using their minds. They supposedly used this heightened state to heal their physical wounds and engage in remote viewing. Because so few people can leave their bodies on command, these experiences are a challenge to study. So friends, how did you find this video? If you like this video, thumb up this video and hit the subscribe button so you never miss one of my videos again. Thank you.